I'm gonna just be honest, this was the greatest interview of all time.
This is Donovan Cockney from Hot Water.
I am Carrie Miller.
Hey, I'm Ross from Prime Circle.
Love, love, love RTL.
My new addiction.
Let me not just talk about it. Let me show you in the back of the window where I'm at.
Cabinet has decided to place the entire country on alert level 2.
No, thank you for getting me out of bed this morning.
Informative.
Relevant.
Diverse.
Interactive.
So educational.
Fantastic. Super fulfilling.
I think most of the time in South Africa, certainly in provincial cricket, they might as well play because there's no spectators going to watch anyone.
They're hugging, shaking of hands, and kissing. Is a thing of the past.
And then overnight into Thursday, we're expecting that cold front to spread showers into most.
The playlist is incredible.
Love the music.
Best music.
Entertaining.
So entertaining.
Entertaining and entertaining.
They wanted radio people because radio people can basically talk shit when things go wrong.
A sight that just a few weeks ago seemed scarcely possible. Eden Park is back in business, a capacity.
No, but seriously, on a serious note, I think I actually swiped right from the one day when I saw you. I didn't know.
No, you didn't.
But you wouldn't know.
And I love dress. If I tell you, I didn't wear a bra, that was so good.
Splashdown.
As you can see on your screen, we have visual confirmation for Splashdown.
I will try to fix you.
You guys are the lifeblood of what's left of this music industry.
And of course, Noel Johnson.
We love your sexy legs.
Especially because of Noel Johnson. Jeez, that man is sexy.
Thank God for RTLSA.
You are a star.
RTLSA.
Home of legends. Legends.
Kavan Investments, an impact venture capital company that turns entrepreneurs' dreams into reality. A core focus is to invest in high growth opportunities to maximize returns for shareholders, at the same time also providing a comprehensive service offering to cover all business needs. From small startups to larger companies, Kavan offers the entire spectrum of service offerings required to get business moving. Visit www.kavan.co.za for more information. Kavan Investments, turning entrepreneurs' dreams into reality. This is your top three on RTLSA.
Brought to you by Creative Design and Print. For all your specialized printing requirements, contact Lauren on 072-114-0329 or lauren.creativedesign@gmail.com.
Own your piece of RTL by sponsoring a feature.
Burning topic. Bad Joke Friday. In other news, Power Play Trivia.
You will be helping keep RTL on air and building infrastructure for as little as 300 Rand per week. Have your or your company's name associated with the fastest growing online radio station in the world.
The RTLSA Top 10. Your top three.
Contact RTL for more info on WhatsApp 064-134-0020 or email info@noeljohnson.co.za. It's time to mass debate on RTLSA.
Playlist is incredible.
Love the music.
Best music.
Entertaining.
So entertaining.
Entertaining.
RTL.
You're listening to RTLSA. You're listening to RTLSA. RTL.
I keep on wanting to say Friday. For some other funny reason, I want to say Friday today. But it's not. It's Thursday, baby. Thursday! One more sleep. One more sleep, and then we are into Friday. But it is Thursday, the 16th of September, 2021. And it happened. Another four people have gone to space. This time, all civilians. They are not scientists or anything. They are tourists, and they've gone to space for 3 days. It's happened. It's happening. It seems like it's becoming a trend now. It seems like it's just another day. Oh, a few more people went to space and whatever. Yeah, interesting. SpaceX has spent a lot of money sending people up on the Inspiration 4 crew. And yeah, they reached orbit. They are now in space for 3 days. Very cool. In our main story today, how easy is it to hire a hitman in the country? It seems that contract killings are up. So if you wanted to hire a hitman, how many hoops would you have to jump through? How difficult is it? Or is it just like a call away? We look more into that in the main story. But right now, it's your headlines brought to you by the SABC.
Let's bring you some news headlines now. Another 4,667 cases of COVID-19 have been reported in South Africa. The National Institute for Communicable Diseases has also reported 166 new COVID-19 related deaths, and that takes the total number of fatalities in the country to 85,468. The number of active cases in the country has fallen to 83,434. The United States, Britain and Australia are establishing a security partnership for the Indo-Pacific as Chinese influence in the region grows. Under the partnership announced by President Joe Biden, British Prime Minister Boris Johnson and Australian Prime Minister Scott Morrison, the United States and Britain will provide Australia with technology and capability to deploy nuclear-powered submarines. And the first all-civilian space crew in history has been launched into orbit aboard a SpaceX rocket ship. Now, the mission marks the launch of SpaceX owner Elon Musk's new orbital tourism business.
Very good morning to you. Let's get you a quick weather update. We are seeing clear skies over the northern parts of the Northern Cape, in places over the northwest and the central regions of the Free State. Other than that, seeing partly cloudy skies over the southern, southeastern and northeastern parts of the country, where isolated showers and thunder showers in places are expected over the eastern and southern parts of the country, but scattered showers and rain along the southern coastline and the adjacent interior and over the interior of KwaZulu-Natal and reaching the coastal regions there for today. South African Weather Service warning of high fire danger conditions, and that is mainly over the northwest and Limpopo. Now, looking at our daytime temperatures, seeing fairly cool to warm conditions over the northeastern parts, but still a cold day over the southern and western parts of the country. Sutherland seeing 15, Worcester will peak at 18 today. Cape Town, a maximum of 17. Gqeberha, a cold day as well with 17. That is with those scattered showers and rain. As you move over the interior of the eastern Cape, Komani will be at 13, Bloemfontein, a cool day with 22. Now tomorrow, seeing clear skies over the northwestern parts again, partly cloudy over the southern and eastern parts of the country. That band now moving mostly to the southeastern and eastern parts, with isolated to scattered showers, mainly thunder showers over the interior. It will be cold in places still over the eastern Cape, but temperatures starting to improve in places over the western Cape. That's your weather. Do stay tuned.
It's Throwback Thursday, and part of Throwback Thursday, we have a look at back in time, especially with regards to music in the second hour of the show. And today what I'm going to do is I'm going to play you segments from the interview that we did with Eddie Kramer last week, Thursday, on SA Commuter. And I'm just going to play little segments of it where he recalls and reminisces about Woodstock 69. And it was thoroughly interesting to hear what somebody had to say that was actually there that day. Incredible. Absolutely incredible. Your top three today is Janet's selection. We've got your PowerPlay Trivia, which is brought to you by Bev Miller. I'll give you that question in a bit. We also look back in history today Yes, we do. And then I was talking about that SpaceX rocket that's gone up with four civilians, as you heard in the headlines. So the burning topic brought to you by Cheryl and Kirsten Murugan. If space travel became affordable for tourism, if it was affordable, would you? Would you go? Would you get on a rocket and would you go spend three days up in space? Let me know via voice notes on 064-134-0020 whether or not you would be keen to do something like that. Today, the days of the year, it is Guacamole Day. Yes, I love guacamole. I love every day that celebrates guacamole. So today is Guacamole Day. It's also Play-Doh Day. So if you know how to make some Play-Doh, why don't you make some? Teenager Workout Day. I tell you what, as a parent, I look around at other people's children sometimes and I think, you know what, those teenagers need some working out. Anyway, that's Teenager Workout. It's also Working Parents Day. Collect Rocks Day. Why don't you collect some rocks? Why not? I don't know what you're going to do with them, but collect them anyway. It's also Step Family Day. Okay, so if you are in a second marriage or third marriage or something like that, it's time to celebrate your step family. Cinnamon Raisin Bread Day. Why not make some for your step family? But most importantly, it is World Ozone Day today. Yes, World Ozone. That thing that covers us and protects us, that our space rockets are flying through all the time. The ozone. And today we celebrate World Ozone Day.
Kaban Investments, an impact venture capital company that turns entrepreneurs' dreams into reality. A core focus is to invest in high growth opportunities to maximize returns for shareholders, at the same time also providing a comprehensive service offering to cover all business needs. From small startups to larger companies, Kaban offers the entire spectrum of service offerings required to get business moving. Visit www.kaban.co.za for more information. Kaban Investments, turning entrepreneurs' dreams into reality.
You're listening to RTLSA. I want to be on lockdown with Noel Johnson.
You're listening to Noel Johnson.
And you're listening to Noel Johnson.
And you're going to party it up listening to Noel Johnson.
As I was saying, you're listening to my mate, Noel Johnson.
RTLSA is proudly brought to you by Kaban Investments, an impact venture capital company that turns entrepreneurs' dreams into reality. Visit www.kabancapital.co for more information.
This is your number one on the RTL Top 10.
As we do on a Thursday, we play the number one from the RTLSA Top 10, as you heard yesterday. And yesterday, of course, coming in at number one was this one from Tom Grennan. I didn't think anything would be different when it came to number one yesterday, because he joined the top 10 like 2 weeks ago and he debuted at number 6, and then he went up to number 3, I think it was, in the second week. And it was only inevitable that he was going to go to number 1. Little bit of love for you on RTLSA. Oh, man, absolutely love that song.
Time to test your knowledge with Power Play Trivia.
Watch your Power Play Trivia brought to you by Bev Miller. Here we go. Squab, S-Q-U-A-B, is a name given to the young of which bird? What is a squab? It's a bird, I'll give you that much. But what type of bird is it? It's a baby of a certain type of bird. Squab. Can you tell me what it is? Send your answer to me via WhatsApp on 064-134-0020. And I'll let you know if you are a smarty pants in just a little bit.
I'm going to just be honest. This was the greatest interview of all time.
This is Donovan Cockley from Hot Water.
I am Carrie Miller.
Hey, I'm Roscoe Prime Circle.
Love, love, love RTL.
My new addiction.
Let me not just talk about it. Let me show you in the back of the window where I'm at.
Cabinet has decided to place the entire country on alert level 2.
No, thank you for getting me out of bed this morning.
Informative.
Relevant.
Diverse.
Interactive.
So educational.
Fantastic. Super fulfilling.
I think most of the time in South Africa, certainly provincial cricket, they might as well play because there's no spectators going to watch anyone.
They're hugging, shaking of hands, and kissing. Is a thing of the past.
And then overnight into Thursday, we're expecting that cold front to spread showers into most.
The playlist is incredible.
Love the music.
Best music.
Entertaining.
So entertaining.
Entertaining and entertaining.
They wanted radio people because radio people can basically talk shit when things go wrong.
A sight that just a few weeks ago seemed scarcely possible. Eden Park is back in business, a capacity.
No, but seriously, on a serious note, I think I actually swiped right from the one day when I saw you. I don't know.
No, you didn't.
But you wouldn't know.
No.
And I love Chris. If I tell you, I didn't even wear a bra, that was so good.
Splashdown.
As you can see on your screen, we have visual confirmation for Splashdown.
I will try to fix you.
You guys are the lifeblood of what's left of this music industry.
And of course, Noel Johnson.
We love your sexy legs.
Especially because of Noel Johnson. Jeez, that man is sexy.
Thank God for RTLSA.
You are a star.
RTLSA.
Home of legends. Legends.
Own your piece of RTL by sponsoring a feature.
Burning topic. Bad Joke Friday. In other news, PowerPlay Trivia.
You will be helping keep RTL on air and building infrastructure for as little as 300 Rand per week. Have your or your company's name associated with the fastest growing online radio station in the world.
The RTLSA Top 10. Your top three.
Contact RTL for more info on WhatsApp 064-134-0020 or email info@noeljohnson.co.za. It's time to mass debate on RTLSA.
It's time to get into today in history. Let's find out what happened. Let's see.
September 16th, 1974. President Gerald Ford announces a conditional amnesty program for deserters and draft evaders during the Vietnam War.
I do not want to delay another day in resolving the dilemmas of the past, so that we may all get going on the pressing problems of the present.
1982, a massacre in Lebanon months after Israel's invasion to drive out the PLO. Lebanese Christian militiamen kill hundreds of Palestinian men, women, and children in two refugee camps in West Beirut. The militiamen are allied with Israel, which is accused of doing nothing to prevent the slaughter. Outrage over the massacre cost future Israeli Prime Minister Ariel Sharon his job as defense minister. 1498. Tomás de Torquemada, the Catholic monk notorious for his role in the Spanish Inquisition, dies in Avila, Spain. 1810. Mexico begins its revolt against Spanish colonial rule. A Catholic priest, Father Miguel Hidalgo, declares his country's independence. His rebellion soon fails, but Spain formally relinquishes its New World colony 11 years later. 1977. Maria Callas, the American-born prima donna, famed for her lyric soprano and fiery temperament, dies in Paris. She was 53 years old. And 1925.
The thrill is gone away.
Guitarist B.B. King, one of the great blues artists of all time, is born in Mississippi.
And you'll
Today in History, September 16th, Camille Bohannon, The Associated Press.
You are listening to.
You're listening to.
You're listening to.
You're listening to Noel Johnson.
Noel Johnson.
Noel Johnson.
On RTL SA.
It's my dear friend Carmen Rodriguez with Like Me on RTL SA. Before that, Justin Bieber with Lifetime and Celine Dion, River Deep, Mountain High, starting off three in a row on your favorite online platform. Coming up, do you want a hitman? Have you thought about hiring a hitman? I'm not advertising services. I'm not advertising the services whatsoever. But how easy is it to get a hitman in the country? Because they say that organized crime or contract killings are actually an upward trend in the country at the moment. And how easy is it to actually contract someone? We have a look at that just on the other side of this.
Kaban Investments, an impact venture capital company that turns entrepreneurs' dreams into reality. A core focus is to invest in high growth opportunities to maximize returns for shareholders, at the same time also providing a comprehensive service offering to cover all business needs. From small startups to larger companies, Kaban offers the entire spectrum of service offerings required to get business moving. Visit www.kaban.co.za for more information. Kaban Investments, turning entrepreneurs' dreams into reality. Own your piece of RTL by sponsoring a feature.
Burning topic. Bad Joke Friday. In other news, Power Play Trivia.
You will be helping keep RTL on air and building infrastructure for as little as 300 Rand per week. Have your or your company's name associated with the fastest growing online radio station in the world.
The RTL SA Top 10. Your top three.
Contact RTL for more info on WhatsApp 064-134-0020 or email info@noeljohnson.co.za. It's time to mass debate on RTL SA.
You're listening to RTL SA. You're listening to RTL SA.
So, I know sometimes you might get frustrated and you might think, if only I had a hitman on speed dial. No, I know. No one thinks like that. Very few people indeed. But it is an upward trend in the country at the moment with regards to contract killings and specifically the hiring of people to do so. So, I was wondering, you know, how easy is it to actually get your hands on hitman? And apparently I wasn't the only one wondering, because the ENCA also were wondering, and I picked up this story from them, and let's have a look at it. It's quite interesting to see how little life is worth and how much it can just be paid for to end. Oh man, let's have a look at it.
Contract killings appear to be on the rise in South Africa. Just recently, a whistleblower died in a hail of bullets. The killing was suspected to be a hit. Currently, as you just heard, a former police officer is in court for allegedly hiring hitmen to kill her relatives for insurance money. So how easy is it then to hire a hitman? Joining us now from Cape Town is Kim Thomas, an analyst from the Global Initiative Against Transnational Organized Crime. Kim, thanks for speaking to us. So that's the question, right? It seems pretty easy to hire hitmen in South Africa, is it?
Hi, good evening. I wouldn't say it's necessarily very easy to hire a hitman, although it is definitely possible. Our research analyzes assassinations in South Africa and globally. And in South Africa itself, we've got a database over the past 21 years, recording over 1,800 hits. And so from that database, we've been able to sort of figure out how these hits are happening, who they're largely targeting, and kind of the point and the focus of really what's going on this landscape of assassinations. And in the majority of cases, they relate to either the taxi industry, organized crime, or political killings. And in these cases, I would say it's fairly easy for hitmen to be hired because people are already criminally connected. And it's in these relationships that they have with gangs or within the taxi industry where they have access to hitmen to make use of or to hire for these hits and assassinations. However, so, in like the, yes.
No, carry on.
In the Ngloba case, which is a personal hit, those are a little bit more difficult because people don't necessarily have the connections. It's also in those cases then that we see that the person hiring the hit is also arrested, as the hitman or person that's been hired to do the hit is more likely to turn them in and just turn state witness or to report on them. However, in the more professional, organized crime, political type of cases, the hitmen are more likely to take the fall as they fear themselves for retaliation.
So in this Ndlovu case, and it's still allegations because the trial is ongoing, it looks like the amateurs have been hired here, but you're telling me that they're professional hitmen in South Africa. This is their job. This is what they do for a living.
Yes. Sadly, I mean, a lot of them also sort of double as what they would call themselves as in this sort of security for the taxi industry or in some political security and also within the Cape gangs. So they won't necessarily exclusively be hitmen, but yes, they are people that get hired professionally as hitmen. And there's various levels of hitmen, and it's the ones that are more professional where we would generally not see the cases go to court because they know how to not leave any evidence. And then you also have your more mid-level hitmen, which are generally what we will see where the hitmen might get caught, but we won't see any of those that are ordering the hit get caught in those cases. But yes, we do have, unfortunately, what we've termed as reservoirs of violence, essentially places where there are histories of violence, dire socioeconomic circumstances, and limited economic opportunity that create a pool of people that are readily available to be hired as hitmen.
Yeah, I'm not going to ask you how, you know, easy it is to get a hold of a hitman because, you know, there might be psychopaths watching the show and we don't want to give them any ideas. But what's the price range like? I'll be interested to know what people pay to actually get another person to commit murder.
So across our database, the price range differs drastically. So in your less professional hits, we're talking about a few thousand rand. And then in your more professional high-profile cases, for example, a few years ago, advocate Pete Mahalik, it was said that that hit in total cost 1 million. So we've got quite a wide range depending on the sort of level of professionality, so to say, of the hitmen and who is hired. Also, how many middlemen are involved in the more high-profile cases. There'll be more middlemen and more people connecting or disconnecting the person hiring or ordering the hit from the hitmen themselves, in which case the hit would cost more money.
Wow. And why haven't police been able to crack down? Since you say that they are professional hitmen, why have they not been able to actually find these people? Are they that smart when it comes to this crime?
I think, sadly, it is quite bad how few cases do make it to court. I think these are very difficult cases to prosecute, difficult cases to investigate. We do see some hitmen going to court. As we've mentioned, people have been arrested, but seeing the trials make it all the way through is also another story. They know what they're doing. They know how to hide or get rid of evidence, how to not leave a trace. And so it is quite difficult, and that's also essentially why they get used. For those that want to eliminate obstacles, it seems to be, at the moment, with this high level of impunity, an effective way to do that.
Since you've been profiling, hitmen in South Africa, who are they? Ordinary people, you wouldn't make them out, don't look, but, you know, weird when you see them.
Well, I don't think you'd be able to point one out in the street or anything like that. But there are people that generally are probably operating in other forms of violence in society, so, or maybe in security industry of sorts. So a lot of our taxi hitmen, from interviews, we found that they also doubled as taxi security, right? So they could be forming a security role for taxi bosses or taxi associations, but then also when they need to take out competition, be it a rival association or someone within the association for a power struggle for a leadership position, then the security can also double as your hitman, for example. Same within the Cape gangs, they could just be ordinary gang members who form other roles in the gang, but then when needed, can also operate as a hitman.
Wow, it's like a movie. Thank you so much for the insight, really appreciate it. Kim Thomas, an analyst from the Global Initiative Against Transnational Organized Crime.
So yeah, there we go. It's actually quite scary how prevalent it is, so to say, in our society. We always watch movies and we always see, okay, hitmen are like specialists and they live in hidden caves and stuff like that, and people have to go via the dark web to find them and whatever. But apparently in South Africa, and I know in a lot of other countries in the world, it's not that difficult.
Daniel,
oh man, let's not do that. Waiting for the hammer to fall right now on Queen, on RTLSA. It's Queen, baby. Oh, yeah. We're going to get into your top three on the other side of this. And today's selection is that one of Janet, I think it was. Janet asked for three very cool songs. They're going to take you a little back in time. That's for sure. You don't want to miss this one. This is going to be a goodie.
Own your piece of RTL by sponsoring a feature.
Burning topic. Bad Joke Friday. In other news, Power Play Trivia.
You will be helping keep RTL on air and building infrastructure for as little as 300 Rand per week. Have your or your company's name associated with the fastest growing online radio station in the world.
The RTLSA Top 10. Your top three.
Contact RTL for more info on WhatsApp 064-134-0020 or email info@noeljohnson.co.za.
It's time to mass debate on RTLSA.
Playlist is incredible.
Love the music.
Best music.
Entertaining.
So entertaining.
Entertaining.
RTL. RTL.
RTL. You're listening to RTLSA.
This is your top three on RTLSA.
Brought to you by Creative Design and Print. For all your specialized printing requirements, contact Lauren on 072-114-0329 or lauren.creativedesign@gmail.com.
You ask for it, we play it. Your top three on RTLSA.
It's your top three on RTLSA, and today was Janet's selection. And wow. Quite crazy, that selection, because it all started off with Crazy Frog by Axel F, and then Chumbawamba Tump Thumping was probably the most, how should we say, normal of the three songs. And then we had You Can't Touch Us from MC Hammer. That's your top three, brought to you by Creative Design and Print.
This is your top three on RTLSA.
Brought to you by Creative Design and Print. For all your specialized printing requirements, contact Lauren on 072-114-0329 or lauren.creativedesign@gmail.com. Right, coming up in the next hour, we play you a few segments from that interview we did with Eddie Kramer last week. That was myself and Janine from SA Commuter. And it flighted in its entirety on SA Commuter already. But today is the first day that we're actually going to play the video from that interview as well. Well, segments of it, so to say. And the segments we're going to play are when Eddie Kramer reflects on Woodstock 69, of course, which he was involved in as a sound engineer. And he worked very closely with Jimi Hendrix and many, many other massive artists in the past. And what a fun interview it was. He's a very, very interesting character with a very sort of dry sense of humor. And really enjoyed chatting to him. And I am toying with the idea of actually using the entire interview for Monday Madness this coming week. But I haven't decided on that yet. But let's have a look at a couple of the segments a little later. And then maybe if you really want to see the entire interview, I will flight it on Monday. We've still got your Throwback Thursday coming your way as well, just after the top of the hour intro. We've got your PowerPlay Trivia. The question today is, Squab, S-Q-U-A-B, is a name given to the young of which bird? What is a squab? Send it to me on WhatsApp via 064-134-0020 if you know the answer. And your burning topic, brought to you by Cheryl and Kistner Murrigan, if space travel became affordable for tourism, would you go? And of course, it's relevant in the sense that right now, there are 4 civilians in space on a tourism expedition with SpaceX. Okay, so would you go? If you had the ways and means and the opportunity, would you get on a rocket and go spend a couple of days in space? Send me your comment via voice notes on 064-134-0020. Very excited to hear what you have to say about it.
Kaban Investments, an impact venture capital company that turns entrepreneurs' dreams into reality. A core focus is to invest in high growth opportunities to maximize returns for shareholders, at the same time also providing a comprehensive service offering to cover all business needs. From small startups to larger companies, Kaban offers the entire spectrum of service offerings required to get business moving. Visit www.kaban.co.za for more information. Kaban Investments, turning entrepreneurs' dreams into reality.
You're listening to RTLSA. I want to be on lockdown with Noel Johnson.
You're listening to Noel Johnson.
And you're listening to Noel Johnson.
And you're going to party it up listening to Noel Johnson.
As I was saying, you're listening to my mate, Noel Johnson.
It's
a blast from the past.
You're listening to RTLSA.
Throwback Thursday. Starting it all off was Journey with Don't Stop Believing. In People Moving On Up. And this one from Ballyhoo, Man on the Moon. And of course, I had Fergie Ferguson from Ballyhoo on the show not too long ago. And it was really cool to chat to him, as this is one of the greatest songs from a South African outfit ever. Bob the Legend Thorne and I are having a little debate. Speak about anal. Okay, so his argument is, I can only use that drop-in if the artist is already dead. My argument is, it is a classic song, so the song is in the grave. As the words of the the drop-in says, rave from the grave. So him and I are a little bit at odds when it comes to this debate. Does anybody care to correct either of us so that we can sort of just get past this, get over this little hurdle in our friendship? If you've got any thoughts or input regarding this. I don't think Bob will ever admit he's wrong. But in this case, I think from a matter of context and perspective, I might be right. Anyway, you gotta love it. I love the interaction and the input from you guys. On the other side of this, we're gonna pick up that piece from Eddie Kramer where he talks about Woodstock 69. And it's the first time that we're playing video segments from that interview.
I'm going to just be honest. This was the greatest interview of all time.
This is Donovan Cockley from Hot Water.
I am Carrie Miller.
Hey, I'm Roswell Prime Circle.
Love RTL.
My new addiction.
Let me not just talk about it. Let me show you in the back of the window where I'm at.
Cabinet has decided to place the entire country on alert level 2.
No, thank you for getting me out of bed this morning.
Informative.
Relevant.
Diverse.
Interactive.
So educational.
Fantastic. Super fulfilling.
I think most of the time in South Africa, certainly provincial cricket, they might as well play because there's no spectators going to watch anyone.
They're hugging, shaking of hands, and kissing. Is a thing of the past.
And then overnight into Thursday, we're expecting that cold front to spread showers into most.
The playlist is incredible.
Love the music.
Best music.
Entertaining.
So entertaining.
Entertaining. And entertaining.
They wanted radio people because radio people can basically talk shit when things go wrong.
A sight that just a few weeks ago seemed scarcely possible. Eden Park is back in business, a capacity.
No, but seriously, on a serious note, I think I actually swiped right from the one day when I saw you. I didn't know.
No, you didn't.
But you wouldn't know.
And I love dress. If I tell you, I didn't wear a bra, that was so good.
Splashdown.
As you can see on your screen, we have visual confirmation for Splashdown.
You guys are the lifeblood of what's left of this music industry.
And of course, Noel Johnson.
We love your sexy legs.
Especially because of Noel Johnson. Jeez, that man is sexy.
Thank God for RTLSA.
You are a star.
RTLSA.
Home of legends. Legends.
Own your piece of RTL by sponsoring a feature.
Burning topic. Bad Joke Friday. In other news, PowerPlay Trivia.
You will be helping keep RTL on air and building infrastructure for as little as 300 Rand per week.
Have your or your company's name associated with the fastest growing online radio station in the world.
The RTLSA Top 10. Your top three.
Contact RTL for more info on WhatsApp 064-134-0020 or email info@noeljohnson.co.za.
It's time to mass debate on RTLSA.
You're listening to RTLSA.
So last week, Thursday, we had the privilege to actually sit down and have a conversation with Eddie Kramer. And Eddie Kramer is legendary in the industry, the music industry. There's working with the likes of Carly Simon, Jimi Hendrix, The Kinks, Eric Clapton, and many, many of the huge artists back in the day. And we got to sit down and talk to him, not only about Woodstock, but also about other things with regards to his career, his book, and stuff like that. But I thought, because being Throwback Thursday, I'm going to play segments that we spoke about in the show, in the interview regarding Woodstock specifically. And this is how it went down. It was good fun, really enjoyable.
I'm sure you've been overwhelmed with questions about your experience at Woodstock. How did you end up there?
In a VW bug. That's how I ended up there.
it's a bit of a
story, but essentially I got a phone call I think a week or so before the Woodstock event from the directors of the movie, Michael Wadley, and he said, you know, you're quite well known for your sounds and everything, and you do a lot of live recording, and you're working with Hendrix, and Jimmy is going to be he's the top of the bill. Would you like to come up and record it? And I said, yeah, sure, why not?
I mean, everything was very casual in those days. Hey, just drive up to Woodstock, record a couple of bits and pieces. We thought maybe it'll be 100,000 people there. Not too bad, right? It turned out to be 500,000 people. Almost, it was a small city. And it was, the only way I can describe it is 3 days of drugs and hell.
Sounds fun.
Sounds like a festival.
Well, it was the most unique festival ever. I think it was groundbreaking, and certainly it made a political statement as well. I mean, apart from the fact that the bands, a lot of the bands were young musicians who were just starting off with their careers, and this made a lot of folks, like you mentioned Carlos Santana. After Woodstock, his career blew up fantastically, as with Johnny Winter and so many of the artists who played there. It was a remarkable event. Well, there's a funny story attached to the actual physical stage itself. If you can imagine, the stage is, there's the audience is up on a hill and sort of sloping down in a sort of a natural amphitheater towards the stage. And on the stage itself, the crew had managed to build a circular substage with wheels on it. And the idea was the first half of this circle, you had the first band, and behind that other half was the second band ready to go on. And all they had to do was turn the turntable and you'd have the next band ready to go. Unfortunately, they try to make the first turn and all the bloody wheels fell off.
So that's where the term, the wheels went away or the wheels fell off comes from.
The wheels fell off, yeah. Great.
And why did Jimi Hendrix want to be lost? Was there something that he's, because I know it was.
No, he was always supposed to close the show. It was supposed to be Sunday night.
Night.
However, if you take into account the weather, the fact that instead of a band going on for 45 minutes or an hour, they would jam and that would last an hour and a quarter, hour and a half, change of, you name it. And so if you take all of those moments, it just backs everything up. So poor Jimmy, who was going to close the show Sunday night, closed the show Monday morning at 9 a.m., which was really not a good scene, but he was magnificent. His performance is searing. It's just one of the greatest performances of his career. And certainly the Star Spangled Banner, that is imprinted into the brains of pretty much everybody who was there. And then the whole nation heard it and went, wow, this is quite something.
That's amazing.
Yeah.
I actually wanted to ask you a question about that, because being physically present when somebody does something so iconic, how do you carry it through for the rest of your life? And I'm sure that you tell the story with absolute fondness. Was that always going to be part of the show, or was it just something that happened?
Oh, Jimmy had been using that to close shows for quite a while. This was the most adventuresome performance. He adapted the way he played it for the situation. And this was obviously monumental, and he knew it. And so he gave it everything he had, I think.
Eddie, do you think that Woodstock set the tone for how festivals in the future should run?
Well, it certainly was a benchmark. I'm not sure if they were going to be run like that. Certainly a massive festival like that, it did set the tone. You're right. I mean, everything that followed was either going to be as well organized or not as well organized. And we are aware of some of the festivals that didn't go so well, where there were riots, et cetera, et cetera. But it certainly, having a big event is still today, if we could do it, we can't because of COVID, but if you could, you would have Glastonbury, you would have all these incredible festivals still cranking.
Eddie, the difference between live mixing and studio mixing, and I'm not talking about necessarily today. Let's talk about in that time. What were the biggest challenges and the biggest difference when you were like doing a live recording at Woodstock versus being in studio with Jimmy doing the recording?
That was a challenge, as I said. I mean, we only had maybe 12 microphone inputs, and you would have to try to figure out how to put a microphone between two drums to get a drum, two tom-toms, you know, that sort of thing. I don't want to go too far into the technical side of things, but it was very restrictive. Only actually on the 8-track machine, there were not even that many tracks for audio because the 8th track was pulse tone for the movie to sync up to. And then you had an audience track, which has also had some music on. So really basically 7 tracks, if you can think about that in today's market, when you have Pro Tools and unlimited, you know, 150, 200 tracks, if you want to. That's the restriction. So you had to really have your act together to be able to pre-mix a whole bunch of drums onto one track, a mono recording. That's the thing. If you can do that, then, you know, you were reasonably successful.
But how do you take something like that, when you speak about a mono recording on the drum track, and turn it into 5.1 stereo, for example?
That is very tricky. It can be done, but it takes a lot of work. You have to actually go in and actually rebuild that mono track and split it up into various frequencies and then send it. I won't go into it. It's too... There are many, many more interesting things to talk about.
Sorry, that's just my musician side coming out there.
I see there was an interview on the 50th anniversary of Woodstock, which was 2 years ago. The couple that appeared on the cover of the album. How were they chosen? I mean, like the photo, did you get a bunch of photos or...
That was something I wasn't involved with. I think the record company, which was Atlantic, I think it was Atlantic, they probably gathered photographs and they had their department that does covers find something that was cool.
And that's how they did it.
Yeah, I mean, I think that's that whole Woodstock thing. I mean, when it first came out, it was, I don't know, there was... The country was going through a lot of stuff. And I think the positive attitude of Woodstock, here's 500,000 people getting together, being very peaceful, and just enjoying music and lifting their spirits. And I think we need more of that.
I think that's what proved that music brings people together. And it has this knack of making things happen. And that's what Woodstock seemed to have done.
It did. It really did.
Jimi Hendrix, Hey Joe, and it was so cool to catch up with Eddie Kramer. It's always a privilege when you get to get these guys out of bed early to talk to you live on air, and they're so willing and eager to give time. And there was so much more to that interview. We speak about Eddie's experience in South Africa and coming back to South Africa after 30-odd years. And the comparison between his memories and reality at the time. I think maybe we should play it as Monday Madness, the entire interview. Lots of interesting things came through. I'm pondering, I'm thinking about it, contemplating it. Right now on the other side of this, we get into your PowerPlay trivia.
Caban Investments, an impact venture capital company that turns entrepreneurs' dreams into reality. A core focus is to invest in high growth opportunities to maximize returns for shareholders, at the same time also providing a comprehensive service offering to cover all business needs. From small startups to larger companies, Caban offers the entire spectrum of service offerings required to get business moving. Visit www.caban.co.za for more information. Caban Investments, turning entrepreneurs' dreams into reality.
Own your piece of RTL by sponsoring a feature.
Burning topic. Bad Joke Friday. In Other News PowerPlay Trivia.
You will be helping keep RTL on air and building infrastructure for as little as 300 Rand per week. Have your or your company's name associated with the fastest growing online radio station in the world.
The RTLSA Top 10. Your top three.
Contact RTL for more info on WhatsApp 064 134 0020 or email info@noeljohnson.co.za.
It's time to mass debate on RTLSA.
You're listening to RTLSA.
Time to test your knowledge with Power Play Trivia.
And today's Power Play Trivia brought to you by Bev Miller. Squab is the name given to which young bird? Species of bird. And I got correct answers from Sarah and Lauren and Bev as well, all saying the same thing. It is in fact... No, hang on, they didn't. Hang on, stop the bus. Lauren got it wrong. Sarah and Bev got it right. It is a pigeon.
Squab is a young domesticated pigeon, usually about 4 weeks old, that is raised for its meat. The practice of domesticating pigeons as livestock probably came from the Middle East. Historically, squab or pigeons have been consumed in many civilizations, including ancient Egypt, Rome, and medieval Europe, and were described as food in the Bible. Texts about methods of raising pigeons for their meat date as far back as 60 AD in Spain. From the Middle Ages, a pigeon loft was a common outbuilding on an estate that wished to be self-sufficient. In the United Kingdom, squab was eaten when other food was rationed during the Second World War, and today, many people continue to eat it.
Alanis Morris had Hand in My Pocket before that. Michael Bolton was Steel Bars on RTLSA, throwing back properly in the second hour of the show today, having an absolute blast of a time. Getting into your burning topic right now, just on the other side of this.
Own your piece of RTL by sponsoring a feature.
Burning topic. Bad Joke Friday. In other news, Power Play Trivia.
You will be helping keep RTL on air and building infrastructure for as little as 300 Rand per week. Have your or your company's name associated with the fastest growing online radio station in the world.
The RTLSA Top 10. Your top three.
Contact RTL for more info on WhatsApp 064 134 0020 or email info@noeljohnson.co.za.
It's time to mass debate on RTLSA.
Playlist is incredible.
Love the music.
Best music.
Entertaining.
So entertaining.
Entertaining.
RTL.
RTL. You're listening to RTLSA.
Have your say now. It's the burning topic.
Well, and I asked you, because obviously SpaceX has taken a rocket with four civilians into space now, and they're there for 3 days. So the burning topic today was, if you had the opportunity and it became affordable to be a space tourist, would you? Would you go there? Would you want to do that? That's what you had to say.
Hi, Noel and RTL listeners. So would I go into space if I had the opportunity and means to do it? Oh, hell yes. Who wouldn't like an adventure like that? I mean, wow. To see planet Earth out of a whole new perspective. Oh, definitely. I would.
Morning burning topic. Yes, I would definitely want to go up to space in a rocket if it was affordable. As long as I could take my whole family with, just in case something happened up there and we never return. So I would be with my family. But yes, it sounds so awesome and exciting. Why not? Why not take that opportunity if it was given to you? Awesome.
Would your family have a say in the matter?
Funny thing is that I can't even afford petrol to go to Gateway. So what's your idea of affordable? No, if I could, I would definitely. How cool is that? You see all the planets and stars and oh my goodness. Yeah, I would go. That's amazing. Cool.
Well, let me tell you this much. Okay. Obviously, I think if I got the opportunity to do it, I probably would. But, you know, it's like, for me, the whole space travel thing is like going to Iraq for holiday. It's not something I particularly would put on my bucket list. Space travel is not something I put on my bucket list. You know, I could think of much better things to do than go and float around in space for 3 days. Well, maybe that's just me. But, you know, for the experience, yeah, I might just do it. But it's true, and it's very possible that it will become a thing in the future. Because this is now, just in the last couple of months, three rockets that have gone up. And all of them have had civilians of some sort to a certain degree. And it's been privately funded and stuff like that. So it seems like it's becoming a reality, space travel. And who knows, very soon you might just be able to jump on a rocket and fly into space for a little bit. And, good for you. If you want to go, if that's something you want to do, then all means do it. But like I said, yeah, I'd go, maybe not adverse to going, but it's just not something I would necessarily put on my bucket list. Don't think so. I'd rather go do some kung fu fighting in Thailand or wherever they do it. You know, that's a good experience. Get your ass kicked by someone else. Probably be a lot cheaper as well. It's Cindy Alter and the Girls from Clout with Substitute, a blast from the past, right here on RTLSA on Throwback Thursday, of course. Before that, Cole Douglas with Kung Fu Fighting. And that's where we're going to leave it for today. No more Thursdays. Done and dusted. Finished. Klar. Over. Which means that it's Friday tomorrow. Yes, baby. Bad Joke Friday tomorrow, 10 a.m. is where it's going to be happening. You are the comedian. You entertain tomorrow, right here live on RTLSA, broadcasting live on sacommuter.co.za as well. So be here for that. Do not miss it. It is going to be super cool. Remember what I always say. If it bugs you, you've got to deal with it, baby. Do not bury your head in the sands. Do not be that ostrich person. Okay? Just take action and deal with it. I'll catch you guys tomorrow at 10. Love you. Long time. Playing out with another classic. Just to end Throwback Thursday in style. Dexy's Midnight Runners with Come On Arlene. Love ya!
Kaban Investments, an impact venture capital company that turns entrepreneurs' dreams into reality. A core focus is to invest in high growth opportunities to maximize returns for shareholders, at the same time also providing a comprehensive service offering to cover all business needs. From small startups to larger companies, Kaban offers the entire spectrum of service offerings required to get business moving. Visit www.kaban.co.za for more information. Kaban Investments, turning entrepreneurs' dreams into reality.
You're listening to RTLSA.
I want to be on lockdown with Noel Johnson.
You're listening to Noel Johnson.
And you're going to party it up listening to Noel Johnson.
As I was saying, you're listening to my mate, Noel Johnson.